Good morning, students. Continuing our online classes, today we will be doing the next chapter, the title of which is The Merchant of Venice. This is a play written by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare is noted for his many plays, a different variety of plays which he has written for all age groups. In this play, the main characters are Shylock. He is a Jewish money lender who lives in Venice. Antonio, he is a small merchant, and Bassanio's friend. Bassanio, he is a gentleman from Venice, a close friend of Antonio. Portia is a wealthy lady from Belmont and Bassanio's wife. Nerissa is Portia's lady-in-waiting and confidante. The Duke of Venice, who is the ruler of Venice, and other courtiers. In this story, we can see that how one friend wants to help the other friend. Bassanio is in love with a lady who is very rich. Her name is Portia. She has lost her parents. However, her parents wanted her to marry someone who would be suitable for her in all aspects. However, Portia loves Bassanio and knows that he, being poor, cannot afford all the riches compared to what she has. However, their love is genuine. One day, Bassanio goes to meet his friend Antonio and tells him that he loves a girl whose name is Portia. However, she is very rich, and compared to her, he is nothing. He asks Antonio for help. Antonio is very disheartened as he cannot help him, as his ships have been sent out to sail. He tells his friend that now I don't have that much of money with which I can help you. However, if you want, then I can take a loan for you. Bassanio agrees to this. They then go to Shylock, who is a Jewish money lender. Shylock is a Jew. Antonio is a Christian. Shylock does not like Antonio because Antonio has always mistreated him, called him bad names, and has made fun of him on several occasions. Antonio forgets whatever he has told him and requests Shylock to lend him 3,000 ducats. Shylock is amazed when he hears that he wants a loan. He tells him that you have so many ships, you are earning so much. So he says, no, I don't want the loan for myself, I want it for a friend. Now, Shylock sees this as an opportunity and decides that, okay, he has made fun of me, he has ridiculed me many a times, so now it is my time that I should do the same with him. He tells his friend that, okay, I will give you 3,000 ducats. However, in return, I don't want any interest. Antonio is surprised because Shylock always wanted interest on the money which he loaned to the people. Here, Shylock plays a game with him and tells him that in case you do not pay me back my money in the stipulated time, then I will cut a pound of flesh from your body. Antonio agrees to this deed. The deed is signed and sealed. The money is given to Antonio. Antonio gives the money to his friend Bassanio. Bassanio enjoys his life. However, Antonio comes to know that his ships have met a fearful fate. All the money that he was supposed to be getting does not come to him because he has lost all his ships at sea during a storm. Now, Shylock sees this as an opportunity to redeem his money from Antonio. He goes to Antonio and tells him that now I want back my money, which you have taken from me. Antonio requests him not to be so harsh, to give him some time. However, Shylock does not pay any heed to his requests. In the meantime, Portia comes to know about all this and is also disheartened. However, she loves Bassanio a lot and wants to help him out. So, she disguises herself as a lawyer and goes to the court. In this, the Duke of Venice had already ordained for a lawyer to take up the case. However, Portia gives a letter to him and tells him that the lawyer who was supposed to come is unable to come because of some reasons. The Duke then lets her take over the case. Portia, disguised as a lawyer, talks to Shylock regarding the case. She tells him that please forget about the money. If you want, then we can discuss it. You can take the money, whatever you want you can take, however, don't take the pound of flesh. Shylock is adamant. He says, I don't want any money, I don't want any interest. Now I only want the pound of flesh that I had bargained for in the deal. After many requests, when Portia sees that nothing is turning in her favor, realizes that nothing can be done. She asks for a pair of balance to be brought and a sharp knife. Shylock is very happy and praises her. He does not know that she is Portia, Bassanio's girlfriend, and he on praising her, he realizes that everything is going to be in his favor. However, as he nears Antonio to cut the pound of flesh, he is in for a rude shock when Portia tells him that you can cut the pound of flesh from any part of his body, doesn't matter. However, the only condition is that not a drop of blood should fall in the balance. Now, Shylock is in for a rude shock. He knows that if he will cut any part of the body, then blood will obviously trickle. He realizes his mistake and wants to make amends. He tells Portia, the lawyer, that he will not take the pound of flesh. He is willing to take back the money, whatever is to be offered to him. She tells him that now you will not get the money, you will not get anything, and whatever property you have will be confiscated because you have made a wrong move. In the end, we can see that Portia wins the case. Shylock has nothing left with him as he has to give whatever he has to the court. Thank you.